Hey, what's going on? This is Brian Pickowicz, and I want to talk to you today about the 8 things that will help you get into amazing shape and build self-discipline. And so when we talk about fitness, it's important that we approach it from a lifestyle, and no lifestyle can actually be livable without habits. And so the most important habit is consistency. And when we talk about building consistency into our life, what we're really talking about is being self-disciplined, being self-motivated, and really being able to align with that disciplined mindset that allows us to consistently show up and do the things that we know we need to do in order to get to where we want to be. Now, the challenge with discipline is that it has that self part in front of it. And I know if you're anything like me, when we're starting on a new path, that's the biggest challenge, is getting ourselves in the position where we can actually get momentum and leverage to move forward. And so today, that's why I want to give you 8 simple steps that are going to help you wherever you're at, whatever your fitness and lifestyle goals are. These 8 steps will help you align on what you actually need to do for yourself in order to move yourself forward. But before we dive in, the thing about discipline is, a lot of times we think of discipline as this huge, overarching, intense driving factor to doing hard things. And now for me, I am a big fan of doing hard things. I used to compete in bodybuilding. I run marathons now. I love pushing my body and I love pushing my mind and myself outside of my comfort zone. But the one thing that I've learned about discipline is, discipline is about understanding where we're at, not comparing ourselves to where someone else is in their journey. So for instance, if you think of someone who's disciplined right now in your life, or you have the image of a disciplined person, you might be thinking of a Navy SEAL. You might be thinking of someone like Jocko Willink, who is an amazing author and former Navy SEAL that I admire for his discipline. Or you might be thinking of a bodybuilder, someone who's really intense with staying on to their diet or their training or whatever it is that you're really aspiring to do. And this image of someone who is over the top and really extremely disciplined can have 2 effects. The first thing is, it can be inspiring. You can look at someone like an Arnold Schwarzenegger and say, wow, he trained for hours on end, I want to go do that. Or David Goggins, and go down that path too. And those are people that inspire me. But at the same time, there's been times where I've looked at people who are disciplined and it's actually been harmful to my progress, because it stopped me from moving forward because I compared myself to them. And you might be in that same position where you see someone on Instagram or you see someone on social media who's posting their workouts and you're like, wow, I wish I could work out 6 days a week, or I wish I could do like that. And this comparison syndrome, this comparison to other people's forms of discipline, can become a negative connotation, or could be something that holds us back if we allow it to. And so that's why today I want to give you these reframes on discipline. I really want us to focus on building discipline from where we're at today. And when we start to improve our relationship with discipline and we see it as something that gives us life and gives us freedom rather than something that holds us back, we're truly able to take that next step and improve on our journey. So the first thing is, define the ideal outcome of your discipline. So for instance, if you want to lose weight, define how much weight you want to lose, define and get specific on what you want as a byproduct of that weight loss, and really get specific on what you gain through that process of being disciplined. Because for instance, if you're just thinking like, oh, I want to lose 25 pounds, and that's the only thing you're thinking about, you're not actually going to have something that excites you, because there's nothing tied to that goal. So when we talk about goal setting, it's really important that we have something that's tied to it that emotionally pulls us forward. So for instance, if you want to lose weight, maybe it's empowering for you to think of losing weight because you're going to feel more confident, or you're going to be able to be more energetic, you're going to be able to exercise and live a healthier life, and that means something about what you're able to do for the quality of your life. But define that target and define the outcome, define the vision and the feeling that you want to have, so that way you can align on the appropriate disciplines to get there. But if you're just trying to wake up at 4 a.m. because it sounds exciting, or if you're just trying to start a 6 day a week workout regimen because you think that's what you have to do in order to get somewhere, it's great to take action and I applaud you for that. But what I find is, it's far more impactful to start with the end in mind, get clarity on what we want, get clarity on how we want to feel as a byproduct of that, and then take the next step. And then the second thing is, start small. So if you're trying to lose that 25 pounds, if you're trying to get in shape, whatever it is that you want to do in this fitness journey, don't dive in the deep end or don't compare yourself to what someone else is doing, but align on what's appropriate for you that pushes you, but that's also in your wheelhouse. And so when we think of starting small, maybe it's training just 3 days a week. Maybe you can commit to training 3 days a week and tracking your food. Maybe you can commit to something that's a little bit more aggressive because you have some experience. But if you're going from a position where you've never exercised before and you're trying to go to 5 days a week, that might not be the most sensible thing. So take a step back, develop the idea that if you do 1 to 3 things that are habitual that you can be consistent with, then they're going to move you forward in the right direction. That might be tracking your food, that might be tracking the amount of water you're drinking. Just make it something that is small and actionable for you in this moment, and you'll see that you can progress with it long term. And the next thing is make it easy. And what I really mean by that is make it actionable. So if you're someone who knows that you get out of work at 8 p.m. and then you have to train until 10 p.m., but you're like, oh, well, I have this idea that I have to wake up at 4 a.m., then that might not be actionable. That might not be actionable to build that habit of waking up and being disciplined in the morning. But it might be actionable for you to wake up a half an hour earlier. For instance, I had a client recently who wanted to start building his morning routine. He wants to start training in the morning, but he had a hard time with that specific action. And so instead of having him wake up for the hour and a half that it would take him to get ready, drive to the gym, go work out, and then drive home, we started with just building a half an hour plan. So I had him wake up in the morning, did a little bit of journaling so he could set himself in the morning, and then I had him do a stretching and a cardio workout that he could have at home. Something that's very sensible, very actionable, and it was simple for him to do. Now, the cool thing about discipline is it gets you leverage. So once we start to get into a specific zone, then we can do what I find is the most impactful, and that's number four, is we can aim to be consistent over adding more. So for this specific person, the goal was for them to do this for 2 weeks, not just a day, not just for 3 days, but to do it for 2 weeks consistently, rather than trying to say, okay, you did it for a day, now we're gonna go and dive into the deep end, and we're gonna go and go for an hour and a half now and make sure that you're waking up with plenty of time to exercise and do all those small different pieces. Instead, if we pull back and we look at how can we be consistent in this moment, how can we really lean into that focus, makes it so not only do we build the habit, but we don't overwhelm ourselves. And when we're not overwhelming ourselves, we're actually doing the things that are in the lane of the progress that we want to make. So for instance, if you're someone who wants to lose weight, if that's what the focus is for you and that's what you want to be disciplined about, the three things that matter are you eating enough for your body? Are you eating healthy foods to lose weight? Are you training adequately, whether that's strength training, cardio, getting your body in motion for your goals? And are you resting enough? And if we focus on those three things consistently, you will see the progress that you want. But if we start to address and adapt all these different pieces that you're tying into your lifestyle, it might not be the most impactful and the most helpful. So stay consistent on what you're doing in your lane, and it will have a massive impact on where you continue to go. And the next thing is be practical. So being practical means doing what is actually best for you in this moment. So it might not be practical or sensible to go to the gym in the morning. It might be practical to just do 10 minutes on the elliptical if you have an elliptical at your house. It might not be the most practical to dive into the deep end and try to read. Like, one of my things I had to be more disciplined about in my life was reading. And the challenge was that I always compared myself to people who were reading a book a week, or I heard these people online who were reading massive amounts, and I was like, well, I'm gonna have to go try to do that. But the truth is that if I just focused on what was practical for me, which was I was starting from zero books, I'm gonna start to read 5 pages a day. And the cool thing about being practical is you can get momentum and leverage and do more. I was able to actually consistently build that habit, and then in my first year of really addressing the habit of reading, I was able to read 20 books. So I'm not telling you that so that you have to follow through on that same action, but it's about understanding what you're able to do practically. In that practical manner is that you have something that's here. You have something that is yours to control. And if you can do what is necessary and sensible for you, then that expands, because habits are like a ripple in water. Once that you hit that single drop, it starts to spread out to other things, and it just grows and grows and grows, and eventually you have this habit and this discipline on autopilot. But if we don't start with something that's practical and we start from something that's way out here, it makes it really challenging for us to see the long-term actionable steps that we want to implement in that area. So with discipline, start with something that's practical and then be prepared. So one of the things I talk about a lot with clients is that the most important thing about discipline is that you do the thing that happens before you have to actually take that discipline action. Now, what that means is if you want to wake up in the morning and go to the gym, you have to also be prepared to get your things ready at night. If you want to be serious about eating healthy, you have to think and plan about what you're eating before you're actually at the restaurant, before you actually sit down at the dinner table. It has to be something that you're cognizant of. Now, does that mean you have to be obsessed with it? No. For instance, a habit that I've been able to build is I used to always think about having to train at night. So it's like, oh, I'm a night person, I'm gonna train at night, because when I was in college, I worked a full-time job. I was working 60 hours a week some weeks, and I was training for my first bodybuilding competition. And so I was really adamant about training for an hour and a half, 2 hours, 3 hours sometimes if I was really going crazy. And what I would do is I would work a full-time shift on Saturday, and then I would go and like eat afterwards and like get ready, and then I would go to the gym all night. And so I always had this habit of training at night. But it wasn't really helping me. I didn't like it anymore. Once I got out of bodybuilding, I was like, well, I like training in the morning a little bit more, and it gets me set for my day and it helps me focus on the things that really matter in my life. And so what I decided was, if I shift my focus and I start to set myself at night to train in the morning, then I can actually build that morning routine of training in the morning. And so the thing I started to do is I took my clothes at night, I would put them out in my dresser, I'd get my workout pants, my tank top, my shoes, and put them out right next to my phone. So when my phone goes off, my alarm goes off, I have that cue in my head, that's the first signal of a habit, and then I've linked that cue to another cue, which is, okay, my shoes are here, my workout clothes are here, it's time to put those on. Once I put those on, I'm in state. So I'm thinking about, okay, now I've got to go to the gym, I've already done this action, and I follow through with that habit, and it's completely changed my relationship with training and also my relationship with my day. Because when we start with the morning, it sets us up for massive success. And so the simple point is, if you are trying to be more disciplined, you have to be prepared for discipline. You can't just wing it. You can't just hope that you find the discipline. You can't just hope that you can surround yourself with cupcakes and just willpower your way. If you focus on being sensible and being prepared, and knowing what you're doing in that moment and thinking about it beforehand, just in a mindful manner, not stressed, not obsessed, but mindfully, it will change everything that you do, and it will make it so much easier to be disciplined. And the seventh thing is, beware of your language. And so one of the things I was looking into as I was getting ready for this video is there was a Stanford study that talked about willpower and ego depletion. So ego depletion is the idea that you have a finite amount of willpower, and throughout the day that willpower will decrease. And so the more decisions that we make, or the more willpower fatiguing decisions that we make throughout the day, the more it gets challenging to follow through with our disciplines. It makes it harder for us to make great choices for our goals. And there was a Stanford study that reviewed this original study that happened in the 1990s. And what they found is that ego depletion doesn't necessarily count for people who have the belief that they have an infinite amount of willpower. So ultimately, our amount of willpower is also attached to our amount of belief in our willpower. And so what I mean is, if you tie it into our language about what we're saying, about what we can actually achieve, or if we tie it into how we're speaking about the discipline that we're implementing, it shows us that our beliefs and our identity, when we actually approach discipline, make the world of difference for how we follow through. So a good example of this is telling yourself, well, I'm not a morning person, I can never wake up in the morning. It's like, when did you decide that you weren't a morning person? For me, I decided I wasn't a morning person when I was in college. Wasn't true. I just didn't have the habit. I didn't have the discipline. I wasn't setting myself up for success. Now, there's something to be said, obviously, for circadian rhythms, having your body's natural sleep cycle, those kinds of things, but we're not really talking about that. We're talking about using our words to actually influence our behavior. So if you're saying, oh, well, I remember a conversation I had with a client. She's like, oh, well, pizza's my weakness. It's like, is it really your weakness or do you just enjoy eating it? She's like, I just enjoy eating it. Now, why is that important? Because when we talk about our words play a role in our subconscious mind. They play a role in our decisions. So if you think about someone who says, oh, I'm trying to eat healthy. Or someone saying, hey, I just don't eat that food anymore. I don't eat cupcakes like I used to. I don't eat donuts all the time. I just don't do that. Those two people have two totally different ways of using their language to actually influence their behavior. And so if you're watching this, it's so important that you align with a form of internal and external dialogue that shapes how you want to show up through your disciplines. So if you want to train, don't try to go to the gym, just go to the gym. Meaning remove the stress, remove the entanglements, and just take action. Now, the cool thing is that we don't have to dive into the deep end. We don't have to be over the top and aggressive. We can start from this simple place and move ourselves forward. But with discipline, it really comes down to this last point, and that is be graceful with yourself, because this takes time. Me, I've run a marathon. I run my first marathon. This is one of my trophies. I won my first marathon this year. I ran a half marathon. I've competed in bodybuilding 3 times, worked with hundreds and hundreds of fitness and online lifestyle clients. And the point is that I'm telling you this because there's been a tremendous amount of things that I have gotten wrong. There's been a lot of times where I haven't followed through my training, or I ate too much food, or I was so stressed about a decision, or I didn't follow through on the action that I planned, or my schedule went out the window, and those things happen. And the point is to see that getting back into discipline is the most important aspect of following through on your goals and your vision, but also be graceful with the process. Be graceful with yourself. I say grace, use grace, be graceful, because it's about understanding that there's nothing you can do about it. And so it's about releasing yourself from the idea that you have to be perfect, releasing yourself from the idea that you have to have all the answers and you have to have the perfect solution right now in this moment, and just deciding to not make things worse than they actually are. So if you're struggling with your nutrition and you have a bad meal, don't make the next one worse. Don't stress out about it. Don't kick yourself. Don't beat yourself up, because you don't deserve it. It doesn't mean you BS yourself. It doesn't mean you make yourself out to be a saint when you're not, or you tell yourself, oh, it's just only 5 cookies. Oh, it was 5 cookies. But it's not the end of the world. And so give yourself the grace, give yourself the space to get back on track, and realize that if you align on the person you want to consistently become, when you fall off the tracks, you just get right back on. And that's the key with discipline. So it's about you. It's about you with where you're at, needing what you need, and showing up how you want to show up in your fitness and lifestyle journey. So I hope this video helped you. If you did love this, give it a thumbs up. I would appreciate you sharing this with a friend. Feel free to let me know in the comments how you are implementing discipline in your life. And right now, I would love it if you subscribe to this channel too. I am aiming to make this a focus for myself in 2020, putting more videos out like this and just helping more people understand that they can have discipline and grace in the same setting for their fitness journey, combining discipline and mindfulness so you can actually live a healthy and fulfilling life. And I hope that you can help me spread this message. I really appreciate it. And that is my 2 cents. So if you love this video, let me know. And that's it. So the 8 things you need is to start with the objective in mind, start with something small, make it easy and actionable, aim for consistency over addition, be practical, be prepared, beware of your language, and be graceful for yourself in this process. I'm Brian Pickowicz. Thank you so much for being here. I'll see you next time. Cheers.